Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. All right, so this reading is a celebrity reading and today I'm actually going to pull on a few different celebrities. All right, so in the comment section, some of you have asked me to read on different celebrities, some of which I have done readings on, but unfortunately those videos were erased. Not purposefully, just technical difficulties. But anyway, so basically these are just celebrities that I'm not interested in at the moment to do just full-blown out readings on. However, I do have a question or two about, the different situations, or the different questions that you asked. All right, so let's just get straight into it without me doing a long intro. All right, so the first celebrity I want to do a reading on is a singer, I believe, by the name of Maluma. He was suggested in the comment section, and the question was, what's going on between Maluma and his girlfriend? To my best knowledge, so I didn't read much up on Maluma, simply because I didn't want to get too influenced by, the whole backstory, of his life or what's been going on, because I want this reading to be as accurate and as true as possible. And if I'm completely off the money, I want it to be as off the money as possible. You know what I'm saying? Like, I didn't want, what I'm reading to be anything, that influences what I say in the reading, because I wanted it all to be, for real, for real. So yeah, but to my best ability, for those of you who have heard of him and know his music or what he does, please give me that backstory in my comment section. I'm very open. After this video, I will look up more about him. But to my knowledge, yeah, he is from Colombia, and yeah, he is a musician. And I believe recently, I'm not sure how recent, but he has a girlfriend. And I did see, I think her name is Natalia or Natalie. And I don't want to say the wrong name, so I'm just going to refer to her as his girlfriend. Just because I don't want to call her the wrong name. And she's a DJ, I believe, which is super cool. We need more female DJs. But yeah, so the question I'm going to ask on his behalf about him and his girlfriend is, yeah, so what's happening? Yeah, pretty much what's happening in that relationship? What's going to happen for the two of them between now and the new year? So let's find out. All right, Tarot, thank you for your energy. Ah, there's stuff already popping over. Thank you for the insight, pulling on Maluma's energy and his girlfriend. What's happening and what's going to occur between now and, let's say, spring 2020. I'm feeling spring 2020. Spring 2020 for Maluma and his girlfriend. Give us insight. More card, universe. All right, thank you. I'm feeling these two cards too for whatever. Let's see, at the bottom of the deck, the world. All right, so there's some changes. Can you all see that? There's some changes that is occurring between, no. Okay, so I'm getting, okay, not changes as in like bad changes, good changes. Like, I'm getting like, like he wants to give her the world, or he wants to take her around the world, or they're going to be traveling around the world. I'm definitely getting some changes. So we have the Temperance card in reverse. So there's something that Maluma is anxious to get done, to do, to unveil, in concerns to his current girlfriend. The Two of Swords. There's a definitely, okay, so this is making sense. There's a decision that Maluma has made on behalf of his girlfriend. Let's tarot, now I'm like excited. Let's see what this is. King of Cups, it has to do with love. I mean, you know what? I am feeling commitment, like commitment, commitment, like the forever kind. Knight of Cups. So he's about to make an offer. You see this knight offering, that cup coming in. He's about to make a solid offer to his girlfriend. We have the, this flips over. We have the Hermit card. So what I'm getting with this situation is, I feel like the girlfriend that Maluma is with now is like, like he was kind of like shut in and shut out and, just kind of in this hermit mode, and like she's brought him out. I'm seeing like parties even, like she's, encouraged him to get out with friends and party more. Like he, you know, he comes and he, like, whatever, whenever she's DJing, you know, like he's around a lot or she's at his shows a lot. But she brings out things, the best in him. That's what I'm feeling like. She brings out the love in him. Like she encourages him to, you know, just be brave, you know. And I know, like, a lot of times we're talking about entertainers, it's like how they're not brave, but, you know, like, entertainment is one thing, but, you know, who you are outside of, you know, who you are on stage or through your music or art or, you know, writing or whatever it is that you do are two different things. But yeah, definitely, like, she brings the best out of him, you know, like she brings, you know, happiness, just purity, you know, like it's almost like, you know, like she renews hope in him. And yeah, there's a decision that he's definitely been itching to do, and he's ready to make a move on this decision concerning love. Let's see what else. We have the King of Wands. Yeah, so this is not something that he's, like, rushing into with action. Like, there's a lot of passion there, but it's like he wants to make sure that this situation is right. Whatever it is that he is, you know, going to be presenting to her. And we have the Four of Cups. So, yeah, like, it's like with her, before her, or what I'm picking up is, you know, he was ignoring, you know, his emotional, you know, feelings before he, you know, got with her, you know. He was ignoring, you know, how he just felt inside about love. I kind of feel like he was kind of let down, you know, by love. And with her, you know, he's come alive again. So, universe, give us a little bit more insight. What's this all about? What's happening between Maluma and his girlfriend? And 2020. All right, so we have success. We have the Ten of Cups that popped out again. We have the Page of Cups. Let's see. We have Death in Reverse, the Star, Knight of Pentacles, Queen of Swords, and the Eight of Swords. All right, so I am picking up that he wants to make a stronger commitment to his girlfriend, maybe propose marriage. I'm not getting that he won't. But I am getting that there may be some drawbacks that come in between him actually proposing to his current girlfriend and not, simply because, you know, these restrictions all have to do with scheduling and career. This is what I'm picking up. You know, new opportunities that are coming in. It's like this Queen of Swords. There may be, like, you know, some miscommunication. But definitely in how he sees her, you know, the Star, you know, the situation isn't ending, you know, but I'm just saying, like, you know, right now it may not be the best time, you know, or I'm getting more so he feels it may not be the best time, even though, you know, he does not have actual blockages, but he may feel like, you know, it's more so like he's trying to figure out the right time to propose to her. There's other things that are going to come in between in terms of work and opportunity, and that may influence his decision to kind of put things off, or maybe it may not. He may choose to just go forth and continue with this relationship, you know, in the path that he wants, because definitely he wants to give his girlfriend a stronger commitment. All right. Thank you all who tuned in for the question about Maluma. For those of you who were curious as well about him and his girlfriend. All right. And I want to move on to the YouTuber Janelle Eliana, or Eliana. I hope I'm not mispronouncing that. And so the question in the comments was, you know, more about her family. As to why did she choose van life. For those of you who don't know, she's a van life YouTuber. Let's find out, her family life. What led Janelle Eliana, to be van life so young? I think that's why so many people are like, whoa. All right. So, universe, thank you for your insight. Thank you for your insight. Thank you for the messages. What led Janelle Eliana to a van life so young? All right. Give me three more cards, universe. Thank you for the interpretations. What led Janelle Eliana to van life so young? All right, I don't want to flip over the cards just yet. I like to be revealed the cards when everyone else is. Give me one more card, universe. What led Janelle and Liana to Van Life so young? All right. Let's see. And we have the Hierophant. So definitely. All right. So I'm getting more than one story. So definitely, yeah. Like, it has to do with family. Like, I'm getting the sense that she comes from a traditional family, or maybe a religious family, and maybe there was some restrictions there, or, you know, almost like I'm picking up there was restrictions based on, you know, the family religion, or the family, just, you know, or just the household dynamic. Though it was, you know, very traditional, very restrictive, you know, very, you know, it's like almost like I'm picking up like her family had a vision for who or what they wanted her to be, or maybe, you know, one parent over the other. And it was like my way or no way at all. And not in the sense of, you know, you're the child, I'm the parent, and I'm disciplining or providing guidance, but more so like, you know, I own you. You have no individuality, you know. So almost like I'm getting like, you know, she was breaking away. But let's see. So we have the Five of Cups. So yeah, I'm sensing that, you know, like that there was a lot of disappointments that she felt within the household, within her family, just not knowing. I'm sensing like a sense of not knowing where she wanted to go, or what she wanted to do, and not wanting to be forced down a certain path by someone. The Five of Pentacles. Yeah, five. And maybe, oh my gosh. And I'm looking over here. There's another five. So there's something about five. Five is, it's very, yeah, this five is huge in some way. And look what's at the bottom of the deck, y'all. Five again. So something about five is super huge. I don't know in what regards five means for Janelle, but there's something with the number five. Maybe, you know, the fifth month of the year, or there's something with the number five. However, yeah, she was feeling very much so left out in the cold. I'm picking up the sense that she did not feel as if she was heard, or if anyone, you know, if she was paid attention to, or if she was even cared for, you know, fully. And this is what left her, I mean, this is what led her to her van life. Then we have the Ten of Cups. Once again, double fives, y'all. So something about five. I'm not sure what five is to her. Maybe she was engaged, and who knows? Because this Hierophant also means marriage, or maybe there was a disruption, you know, in the household. With, I'm not sure if her parents are married, with the parents, their marriage, or maybe it was a situation, a parent, if they were single, you know, or getting remarried. I don't know, but something with the number five. Ten of Cups. She was not happy. She went off on this journey to find happiness, you know, to find a life where she, you know, it's like she's trying to find out where she fits in, how she fits in. She's figuring out her life for herself. That's what this is all about, this journey that she's taking. This is more so a journey, you know. It's not even like a YouTube thing. That's what I'm picking up. Like, it's a journey that, you know, now she's documenting, because it's like, hey, the fun of it. But yeah, like, she has not been happy. And yeah, this is her, you know, finding her happiness. I am hearing like 25, she's going to be, you know, more settled in terms of a location. But, you know, I am hearing 25, she's going to be more settled. But yeah, but right now she's trying to just fully find herself, find her own way. Wow. Five of Swords. Oh my gosh. Yeah. Something with the number five is huge for her. All fives except for this 10, which is a double five. Like, the wow. Okay. So yeah, like, she was escaping deceit. Someone was being manipulative with her. Someone's being deceitful with her. I am picking up from this card, though, that this was this decision for her to do van life. This candle was like, this was like the first thing smoking for her. This was like, you know what? I'm going to do it. I don't care, you know. Not that she didn't, and I'm almost picking up, not that she didn't care about her life, you know, life or death, but she was so much trying to get out of the situation at home, you know, whatever this traditionist situation was, that she just, it's almost like she just picked up and went. And it's like, yeah, okay, I'll do van life. I've always had an interest in that. Let me just do that. But I can definitely tell you something with the number five is huge. Maybe, I don't know, but, and I'm picking up that 25 is going to continue to be a huge year for her. I am picking up though that we may not see her in the long term in the, like, as this like huge big forefront type of person. I believe I told that to you all in the reading that I did on her personally, that she's not looking to, you know, necessarily take these, like, you know, Hollywood, like, just be thrust in front, you know, like, she wants a quiet life. She just thinks, I'm more so picking up, she thinks it's cool to document her experience because she's living a very cool life. It's very, you know, it's an alternative way of living in terms of what you normally think of when you think of, you know, a person living on their own. You think of them in a stable home, you know, not a mobile one. And yeah, this Five of Wands, I could definitely tell you there was a lot of strife, a lot of arguments, a lot of upset. Just, I'm feeling someone who's very, you know, there was like mild depression there, you know, not severe, not something where she would have needed, you know, long-term help, but just she was a very unhappy, and I am picking up she's been unhappy for a long time, since she was a girl, you know, like in terms of young girl, you know, like, yeah, since she was a young girl, like, picking up 13, like, there's been a lot of unhappiness there. And literally with this van life, she took the first thing smoking that got her out of the house, or out of her situation, you know, and thrust into finding her happiness. And I am getting that she's a lot happier on her own because of the turmoil that was going on in her past life, in her family life. All right, you all. So I hope that satisfied your fancy in terms of that question. Okay. So, and I almost didn't want to ask this next question. This is concerning Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper. So when I said I had done a celebrity reading, when Bradley and his girlfriend broke up, I had done a full-blown reading on the two of them. And yeah, unfortunately, that was one of those videos that was erased. And it was juicy, juicy, juicy. And so in my comment section, I had revealed that in the reading that, yeah, some of the questions I asked were pertaining Gaga and Bradley. And yeah, what popped up is that no, they're not going to pursue a relationship, for the simple fact. And actually, what more interesting that popped up was that, you know, they aren't really very much compatible as, you know, as what it seems, you know, like from, you know, everything that we've seen, you know, with The Star Is Born and all that promo and all that, you know. However, there were some uncomfortable moments, you know, for Bradley's girlfriend, ex-girlfriend, you know, in regards to that. However, yeah, that's what surprised me when I did the initial reading was that, you know, it wasn't there. And what I can tell you is, juicy, juicy, the both of them did think about it. They really did put their best thought forward. And Bradley wanted to pursue it more so than Gaga. And this is what came out in that reading that never was, that the one I could not put up. Bradley wanted to pursue it more than Gaga, but Gaga was more so like the voice of reason of like, no. And that's more so because Gaga felt that, you know, it would stop her in her career and it would put the wrong light on her. And as you all know, Gaga is, you know, an artist, however, you know what I'm trying to say? Like, she's very serious about her career, very serious about her art, very serious about, you know, just everything that represents her. She's very particular, you know, what we see about Lady Gaga, even the, you know, the things that just look outrageous and wild, everything is in its perfect place. That's what I can tell you about her. Like, nothing is on accident, you know, so if it looks outrageous, trust me, it's not out of nowhere. And it wasn't not planned. So she's very strategic, you know, very strategic. And, you know, honestly, that's a great thing. And this is why she has the career that she has. So the question, so I bet you're wondering, like, so what are we going to ask then? So the question I want to know in regards to Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper is, what can we expect from the both of them, either jointly or separate? I'm going to pull, just, you know, just ask the question to see what comes out in the year 2020. So, universe, thank you for the energy, calling on Bradley Cooper's energy and Lady Gaga's energy. What can we expect from both Bradley and Lady Gaga, either together or separate? Please let us know for the year 2020. Okay. Bottom of the deck, you all. The hair bun. Oh my goodness. Okay, so yeah. And I can tell you right now what I got, the feelings that I got with that hair font. Something tells me to pull a romance oracle card. Pull a romance oracle card in their behalf. But I'm going to get to what I felt from that hair font in reverse. All right. So what can we expect between Bradley Cooper and Lady Gaga in the year 2020? Okay, let's see what's at the bottom. Give your relationship a chance. Look what's at the bottom of that one. All right, everyone. So what I felt with that hair font, definitely it was relationship vibes. And we're going to see what the rest of the oracle and the tarot says. But what I felt more so in regards to that is, this is them choosing to not go forth with that situation or... okay, so I am picking up, even if there's like some party and some fooling around, but just not be public, not really explore that situation, because there are feelings there. I can tell you that from what I've been picking up. There are feelings there. There's attraction there, you all, but they're making, remember I told you Gaga is strategic. She's making a business decision. Bradley, he's quite crafty and smart too, so it's a business decision. They're going to choose themselves first in terms of their career, the overall good, what's going to make sense, what's going to create legacy for themselves and their families and whomever in the business of Hollywood. All right, so we have the Ten of Wands came out in the upright, so let's see, and this is in regards to what's going to happen between the two of them in the year 2020. The Ace of Swords in the reverse. We have the Magician. Yep. Relationship isn't going to go forth, you all. So for those of you who are Gaga Bradley fans, the relationship isn't going to pop off. Three of Cups. So yeah, there will be partying. They're going to see each other out. There will be partying. I'm not getting collaboration vibes as of yet. We have the Nine of Wands in the reverse. We have the Hanged Man. Yeah. So yeah, there I am picking up that they will. So Bradley and Gaga, I am picking up that they will work together again in the future sometime on another project. But just 2020, I'm not picking up that they're gonna have anything in terms of projects coming out together. We have the Five of Cups. Yeah, in terms of romance, man, I just heard Bad Romance in my, I'm going to link that. And not that they have a bad romance. Like, I'm not getting a tumultuous, nothing crazy like that, it's more so like when I heard Bad Romance, it's more like that ran through Gaga's mind. Like, you and me will have a bad romance. Like, it's like she does not see it happening, She does not see it happening, She could see them having fun. She could see them hanging out as friends. She has more friendly vibes towards him, even though there is some attraction there, but there's still the friend vibes, the platonic vibes are stronger than the attraction vibes. I am picking up that they may or may not. It's like, okay, if they ever fool around, it's on a drunken night. It's on like almost like on a dare. It's like a, so what do you want to do? But I'm not picking up like, they're going to just, jump because she feels more friend vibes towards him. And it's like he feels that for her, too. Like there's love there in the sense of like, man, I really care about you, man. I want to see you happy. But not that if you go off with another person, I'm going to be jealous. That type of love. The Queen of Cups. See, yeah, there's love there, but I'm not picking up strong romantic love. Like I want to be with you forever. Love. I am picking up. Yeah, there's attraction there. Definitely. Bradley is very much attracted to her. Gaga, she thinks he's a handsome man, but not like, I want to jump your bones. So I'm not picking up in terms of project. I am hearing that they may start working together. 2025, like 25 has been popping up for me, but maybe 2025, but they will work together again on another project. They will work together again, but I'm not picking up in 2020. I'm picking up, more so party vibes. I'm picking up more so like Gaga is, Yeah, Gaga's going to be figuring out what she's going to be doing next in terms of music. That's what I'm picking up. I'm not really picking up movie projects from her. Yeah, this Two of Cups, like this is friendship in this one. So sometimes this could be engagement or couples coming together, but in their case, this is them being friends, you know. And yeah, this Three of. So yeah, with this Hierophant, yeah, they're going to, you know, choose not to go forth with any romantic relationship. It's almost like I can see them, like it's like they've embraced for a kiss. And you ever seen those in a sitcom or like, you know, in a show plot where the two characters that you always thought should be together come together and then they go, nah, you know, it's like, well, we tried it, it didn't work. But yeah, there's still a lot of heartbreak, you know. I'm picking up this heartbreak when Gaga's in. Like Gaga is like at a point where she's just trying to release old energy, not old exes. I am picking up that she's over people, but just old energy of, you know, I want something that's going to work, something that's going to last. And then yeah, Bradley and himself, you know, have, you know, things to tie up. And I'm also hearing that there may be a rejoining between Bradley and his ex-girlfriend. So, but yeah, we have codependency. So yeah, they definitely much so, you know, have become friends. They will, you know, they speak a lot to each other about relationships, I can tell you that. True love. So in this case, what I'm picking up is there's a lot of love between the two of them, but it's going to pan more out into platonic love, you know. I do have the feeling like what's coming up is that they've tried it. It's like they explored the thoughts within themselves. They may have even embraced or kissed or tried to, you know, but it's like it was more so like, I can't do it. I can't do it. I'm just not feeling it. It's like almost like it's weird because there's a lot of love between them, but just yeah, romantically it's not happening. But yeah, they've become really good friends. They really trust each other. We have chemistry. Yeah, clearly they have a lot of chemistry. I mean, like they sold A Star Is Born, and you all like Hollywood has been remaking and trying to remake and wanting to remake A Star Is Born like a bajillion times over. And I can tell you this right now, the remake of A Star Is Born with Gaga and Bradley was not the last remake. Like Hollywood will continuously recycle that movie. So clearly they had that chemistry on and popping. We saw that. And for them to, and reason what I'm saying about the whole Hollywood spill is for them to resell a movie that has been made 99.999 million times. Oh yeah, they got chemistry out this world, you know, but they work well together, and that's what they're going to keep their focus on in regarding and releasing exes. So yeah, they lean on each other a lot for emotional support, you know, like he goes to her for advice and she goes to him for advice. You know, they're just friends, you all. That, see, it came out. They're just friends. And it's like if they were to ever give this a chance, like they could possibly, this could be something, but they don't have it in them to, you know, they what I'm picking up is they rather, you know, they know that they work best together in the capacity that they are in now versus, you know, they're afraid almost like why ruin a good thing? That's what I'm picking up. All right. Thank you everyone who tuned in to these questions. All right, so thank you everyone who tuned into this video for those three questions. Let me know how you felt in the comment section. And yeah, I will be getting back to you all next video. Wherever you are in this world, I hope that you are happy. I hope that you are at peace, and I hope that you are enjoying yourself. All right, till next time, peace and blessings. Goodbye.